I'm Blake X, and this is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So we are back in the Atomic Underground, and once again, shining a spotlight on a band that I've never heard before, another genuine first-time reaction, and this one is another request. This was requested by Steve Stahl, who runs a really awesome page on Facebook called Brutal Female Fronted Metal. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. He's also a patron and a supporter of the channel, and he requested that I check out the band The Machinist and the song No Peace, along with the official music video, which, fingers crossed, I hope does not get blocked. Now, he didn't really spoil the lyrics or anything, and I have those below in the video description, very conveniently, so I'm going to get to those after the music, as always, but he did kind of tell me a little bit about part of the theme of this song, and I think that this is going to be a very dark and very heavy song. Not necessarily heavy musically, although it may be heavy that way too, but heavy in the sense of, I think that it deals with something very, very serious, a very serious problem in the world. And of course, I'll get into that when I do my analysis, but I want to see what they do here. I want to see what the video is all about and how the music itself sounds. So I'm very excited to get into this. And yeah, I don't think I'm going to waste too much time talking on this one. I just want to hear how this band sounds. Genuine first-time reaction. And don't forget to check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions and the Facebook group, The Mushroom Cloud, and the merch store, Y'all Nuclear Shop. Links to all these things will be in the description beneath the video. All right. And don't forget to support your underground bands. If you like this band, definitely check them out. And I'll leave all their relevant social links in the description as well. All right, let's see what this band's got. Let's check it out in 3, 2, 1. Go. Okay, so here's what I'm kind of getting so far from the video. I think that this is someone who did something pretty horrible to this woman. And I'll get into what after the video itself. I want to see if you guys pick up on it. I definitely am. Someone who did something horrible to this woman and basically her getting revenge and punishing him for it. That's what I think this is about so far. And I think that it's shot very well. I like the camera angle that it has. I just like the way that this is filmed so far. It really captivates you right away. It really gets you into the video. It really gets your full attention. The music is also doing that, though. Like, I really like the music so far. I really like her vocals. I like the atmosphere in this. There's, like, a very heavy underlying atmosphere that I think is really cool. But yeah, I do think this is dealing with a very serious subject matter, so we'll see where it goes from here visually and what else they do with this video. But very interesting so far. Let's keep it going. Very talented vocalist guy. atmosphere, though. It was crazy. Kind of surprised that YouTube allows this video. I mean, no complaints here, man. I mean, I have no problem with this. I mean, and once again, I'll get into exactly what this video is dealing with after the song itself. But a lot of bands, it seems like they no longer take that risk. They no longer have very bloody, very gory kind of videos. And I don't think that this is a depiction of like shallow or exhibitional kind of violence. I think that this is very much about the emotions and the rage and the hate that this person feels. A lot of it justified. I think this is about a victim who has been hurt very severely by someone and who wants to get revenge. And I think that you kind of need the sharp imagery and the brutal imagery that's going on here to kind of drive home that point. Because I think this is dealing with something that gets glossed over quite a bit, even within metal. And when it is handled, it's handled in a way that's very, that can be very blasé and very forgettable, and that doesn't have a lot of impact on the listener and on the viewer. I think this video is the very opposite of that, and it's doing an excellent job of conveying a certain message, which once again, I'll get into that after I hear the music, but so far, I really like this, man. I like the video. I like the visuals. I really like this vocalist. I think she's extremely talented. And the atmosphere, I gotta say, is probably my favorite part of this song. Like, I think that's really what makes the song for me. That's what really gives it its magic and its power, for me as the listener anyway, in my opinion. So really good stuff so far, man. And again, I think it has a very dark theme, and I can't wait to get into the discussion on that. Should be very interesting. So let's finish it up. I like the perspective that's shot from. Well, when you're in that much pain, I guess you would light yourself up, you know, at that point. Yeah, very, very well done video, man. I really liked it. I have zero issue with the gore. Like, that's never bothered me. You know, it doesn't offend me in any way. I think that it was, in the case of this video, I think it was very necessary. And it was not empty. It was not shallow. It was not gratuitous. I don't think that at all. Some people who just look at this video on its own, on a surface level, might think that. They might come to that conclusion. But if you really think about the message of this song, and I'll get into that once again, I'll read the lyrics and everything, I think that it was appropriate. Sometimes you need very heavy and very violent imagery to get across a certain message and to hammer a certain message into people's heads. So, very, very well done video. I like the way that it was shot once again. I like that it was shot from the perspective of this person who obviously did something horrific to this woman. I like the way that it ended. I like the ferocity that the visuals had. They went along perfectly with the music. And the music itself was very, very good. I think I have to check out more from this band. You know, the vocals were great, but the main thing that I really enjoyed about this song musically was the atmosphere. Like, that's what really made the song for me once again. You know, it would have been not quite as memorable for me, I think, and not quite as captivating without that atmosphere. I thought that was really cool, and it also added a really particularly dark element to the music that the song would be lacking without that. It was a very important part of this music and contributed a lot to it. So that's kind of what I think about the music. And with that being said, let me get to the lyrics here. Hi, yes, you're alive, more like half dead. My clothes have been stained red with all the blood I've spilled. You die, I live, no fucking guilt. Karma's a bitch, you deserve this. For all those you play, you now feel worthless. There'll be no making peace with God. Confront your demons as they drag you straight to hell. There'll be no forgiveness, I am the only witness. There was never a way out. Stay down, surrender to me. I am the one that you seek. As above, so below. You've always owed me this, your soul. I am the only God you know. I like that line. You've always owed me this. And then the lines just kind of repeat. So I will say this. Yeah, I have to be critical here. I have to be honest, like I always am. I think that the lyrics are a little bit lacking. I think that they communicate the message that this band wanted to get across. But I think they could have been a little bit more well done and there could have been more substance in the lyrics. But I think the video and the music make up for that. Whatever the lyrics lack or wherever they are lacking, in my opinion, the music and the video both serve to fill those gaps very well. So I kind of want to take away points for the lyrics because they don't move me quite that much, but the music and the video are very much the opposite. So it all kind of balances out in a way, you know? Okay, now let's get into this very serious subject behind this song. So from what I was told and also what I picked up on in this video, I think this is about a revenge killing of a rapist, most likely at the hands of the victim herself. So I think this is the expression of pain and anger that a rape victim has, or would have. This person has basically been damaged past their breaking point, and they respond by getting the ultimate payback. Of course, personally, I think the best form of vengeance is justice. I don't think that the two are always mutually exclusive, and I do think that you can potentially get that revenge through the criminal justice system, by pursuing justice and by making sure you hold criminal accountable for his actions. And I do think that people who commit sexual assault and rape should be treated with the full extent of the criminal justice system, like with the harshest sentence possible. I don't think that we as a society should show mercy on criminals who commit horrific acts on that kind of level. But it's also obvious that there are so many issues and that there's so much corruption in our justice system, especially concerning the area of rape. And I'll circle back to that in a few minutes, because I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here. Before we even go there, we have to first acknowledge the deep-seated problem with how men in our society view and treat women. We have a major, major problem with sexual violence against women. That's undeniable, and especially in this country. Like, I can't speak for other countries, but in the US, it's very prevalent. And some of the roots of it are, unfortunately, embedded in our popular culture. And I'm not equating everyone who hypersexualizes or objectifies women with being a rapist, okay? That's not what I'm saying here. But I am saying that those actions nudge the door open further and further for people who are sick and who do want to brutalize women in this way. It creates a larger and larger space for them to falsely justify their thoughts and actions. And I say falsely because there is no true justification for sexual abuse in any form. You know, rape is rape, evil is evil, plain and simple. And I don't think that there are many cut and dry issues in this life, but that's one of them. Sorry, not sorry. How she dressed doesn't matter. How much she had to drink doesn't matter. None of that allows you to commit the ultimate violation of another human being. And the fact that we have some people who are willing to just sit back and let rapists use these things to defend their actions is something I find to be really disgusting, because it's an action that is inherently indefensible. And it's just so insane to me, you know. Let me put it this way. If someone brutally and premeditatively murders another human being, and it's proven in a court of law, you wouldn't ask the killer if the victim dressed in a provocative way to incite your actions. You wouldn't try and invent these paper-thin reasons to dismiss or justify the behavior. You'd condemn it out of hand. So why are we treating rapists with kid gloves? And of course, the irony is that this video involves brutal premeditated murder, but I'll address that in a bit. But here's the thing. That kind of dehumanizing, degrading attitude that we see in terms of how so many rapists are seen and dealt with by the justice system. You know, people like that Brock guy who raped that woman and got a slap on the wrist, essentially. And then his father actually tried to defend him, you know, saying that he shouldn't have his life ruined for getting a few minutes of action, you know, and trying to redefine what he did as, what was it called, outer course? That's what he called it. It's not rape, it was outer course, you know. really sick stuff, man. You know, we live in a fucked up world. But that kind of attitude very much grows out of how our society has been molded and how women are treated culturally, socially, even economically, if you want to talk about things like equality of pay or exploitation of sex workers. The more you see someone as an object or as a resource instead of a human being, the less you express your own humanity and the more you lose your own humanity. Because rape is one of the most inhuman behaviors in my eyes. You know, to me, it's like the most cold and the most degenerate crime that you can possibly commit. You know, it's like someone who does this to another human being is, to me, someone who has lost their spark of humanity. Like, it's just, it's a total violation on every level. And there is no room and there is no place in our society where anyone should say or even entertain the idea that any part of this is even remotely okay. Plain and simple, like straight up, like I'm not going to mince words with this, like wrong is wrong in this case. And this is very much a black and white issue. Rape is rape. There are no shades of gray. It doesn't matter what she was wearing. There are no possible ways to justify or excuse or dismiss this in any way or in any form, no matter what happens in the real world and no matter how much corruption there is in our justice system. There is no fucking excuse for this. It's just wrong. And now when we get to the brutality and the savagery of this music video, I'm not mad about it. You know, in fact, I think it was very well done. And it isn't meant to be taken literally. I think most people know that. But for anyone who doesn't, Captain Obvious here, I'm going to just say that. It's meant to display the hate and the rage that this victim feels after what was done to her. Which, you know, again, there are plenty of songs out there that deal with this subject, but express the more vulnerable and traumatic side of being a sexual assault victim. And this one does embody that to a certain degree, I think. But it also taps into the angry side of things. The fire of pain within someone who wants to do something to the abuser, who wants to see the abuser punished. And it's not wrong to think that way. You know, I'm against unjustified hate, but I'm not against all hate. I very much think that murderers deserve hate. I think that rapists deserve hate. They do despicable and unforgivable things and commit crimes that should not be forgiven. Just like it says in this song. I don't believe in forgiveness for everyone. That's not what I'm about. That's not my personal philosophy. And so I don't think it's wrong to think this way. I just think that it comes down to making serious societal changes and reforming the justice system in terms of how these kinds of criminals are processed. Because I think we need to start dealing with them a lot more harshly. I don't believe in turning the other cheek, you know? So to me, the killing in this video is just the artistic expression and the outpouring of the terrible hurt that lies inside a rape victim. And it also drives home the point how wrong this is, like, which you would think people would understand that instinctually, right? But we have proof within our very society that that's increasingly not the case. And I'm a firm believer that dark and heavy imagery should be used to shock people out of their apathy and to move them to action. And this video accomplishes that because it confronts us with something very uncomfortable that we'd rather not think about because it's so disturbing. And that's one of the beautiful things about metal, that it's not afraid to get in there and get into that dark part of life and to deal with very serious and very traumatic things. And I look at it this way. People who are rape victims have to live with the trauma. They have to deal with this, with what happened to them. So the least that other people can do, and especially men, is to give it their attention long enough to realize that things need to change. And this goes for normal everyday guys who have no intention of ever harming women as well. I think that because of what decades of popular culture and pornography and inequality, all these things, because of what these things have seared into people's brains, plenty of men still unintentionally objectify women. And again, that plays into creating an atmosphere where women don't have basic respect and safety. So it's on us to correct that way of thinking, you know, plain and simple. And I just want to clarify what I'm saying here, by the way. Don't call out rape culture just a virtue signal. Don't do it for good guy points. Don't do it to defend women, because the presumption that women need men to defend them is another form of unequal treatment that's been burned into our consciousness. Don't do it for any of those reasons, okay? Do it because, as a man, you have a perfect opportunity to call out the shitty behavior of other men. And this isn't some social justice thing. Again, this isn't political. This is just about human decency. You know, it's a moral good to try to stamp out things like rape. And it really isn't hard to not play into the culture that contributes to it. I mean, no one looks at people who do like cancer walks or call out animal abuse as SJWs or snowflakes. You know, those people never get called that. So that's a really shitty defense, and it doesn't hold up against the sexual abuse of another human being. Again, it's indefensible, and this song and video was a ferocious and bloody reminder of that. So, look, job well done, man. I gotta say it. And a lot of people won't get, probably, that this is about rape, but I think it was the right decision and a smart move to not depict, you know, sexual assault or rape in this video. We've seen that over and over again. We've seen it in TV shows. We've seen it in movies. And 99 times out of 100, it's exploitive and disrespectful. It's not done well. It's done in a way that just further dehumanizes the victim. And so that's a very fine line to walk when you're trying to depict that kind of scene. And I think we've had enough of that. We don't need to see that anymore. I think that by going this route and choosing to depict the victimizer being punished in this video, I think that was the right choice on the band's part, and I'm glad that they decided to do that, even if the deeper meaning behind this won't be understood by every casual listener. I think people who really sit down and pay enough attention to this, and to the lyrics, and to the music, and really think about what's going on in the video, I think that they'll get the message with enough careful thought and careful attention. So, I think it was very well done. Again, I do feel that the lyrics leave something to be desired. They're a little bit too simple and too repetitive to me. So that's one criticism that I'll make. But at the same time, this band is very much in a hurry to get to the point, and the point is really what matters here. So, again, a very dark and a very weighty issue, man. You know, this is, you know, it, again, this is one of the most disturbing things in the world, I think. To me, anyway. It just, it really bothers me that in any way, shape, or form, this is acceptable to someone out there on any level. And it matters. It has repercussions. It has a ripple effect on society and on culture, the way that we treat or mistreat women. And we've got a lot to learn, and we've got a long way to go. You know, everyone likes to think that we're so advanced now and we're so much better than we were a long time ago. Then why does shit like this still happen? And why do people still get away with it? You know? So this addressed a very real thing. And this was probably something that was very hard for the band to talk about. I don't know. And I'm not assuming or judging, but I don't know if there's any personal experience here with any of the band members with this. But yeah, I think this was very necessary visually and musically. It was very much on point, and it sounded really good too. Which, given the subject matter, I almost feel kind of guilty about banging my head to it. But hey, it was good music. So I really like this band, and I really want to hear more from them. The only weak point for me, again, was the lyrics. Musically, I think I enjoyed it 100%. And the message... the message does make me uncomfortable, you know? I don't like thinking about this. Most things don't bother me, but the subject of rape, it just really, it can be pretty upsetting to me because I don't like to see people exploited and stripped of their humanity that way, stripped of their right to say no, stripped of their autonomy. You know, it's a complete violation once again, and that's what's so sickening to me about it, you know? And obviously, it should be sickening to everyone, but we live in a world where it isn't and where it gets swept under the rug. A lot of other important issues that don't get the proper treatment. So a song like this is very, very important and very necessary, even in the year 2019. Maybe even especially in the year 2019, you know? So Steve Stahl, thank you for the suggestion. And once again, I really respect this band for daring to make a song like this. So this will probably go on some playlists, but this is a song that, once again, could put you in a very heavy mood, you know? So it would have to be the right place, right time, but very, very excellent. I'm going to give this one a very strong 11 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. Comes very close to being a 12, but there is that criticism of the lyrics. I think there's room for improvement there. That's just my personal opinion. Otherwise, I thought everything else about this was great, and people need to hear this shit, man. They really do. So much respect to this band. All right, there you have it. My review, my analysis. Thank you so much for the support, guys. Thanks for checking out these videos and these songs with me. Thanks for being a part of the Nuclear family. And don't forget, if you haven't subscribed, please do. And check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions if you're interested. And also, again, if you like this band, show them your support, check them out, buy their music. I'll leave all the relevant social media links in the description. So that's all I've got for you guys. Hope everyone's doing well out there, and I will catch you all on the next one.